Hello, Eurovision party people. Welcome to Eurovision is my religion. Eurovision week is already upon us, and we are serving you a newbie's guide to semi-final one. I'm your host today, Gerda, and with me I have the oracle predicting Ukraine's win from the very beginning, Kotrina.
Yes, and all of a sudden I have more confidence about this prediction.
Yes, we've been making fun of you for predicting it, and I'm changing my mind. But more on that later. And most likely turn up to a Eurovision party wearing jean shorts in support for Finland, August. Definitely no rules. So, for those living under Eurovision rock, the semi-final one is on Tuesday this week, and we have 15 countries participating in the semi-final, but only 10 will make it to the final on Saturday. Important to note that this year, only the televote counts in the semi-final voting, and the voting will start from the very first performance of the night. So, no need to wait till the very end of the performance to clock those votes in. And we're going to quickly run through the countries participating in the order of the appearance and comment on the bookies' predictions on who will most likely qualify or non-qualify to the grand final on Saturday. As ever, we have opinions about whether the bookies are indeed correct or very unlikely to predict the right outcome, so more on that as well. So, to kick us off, the first performer of the night is Cilia Capsis with a song Liar, representing Cyprus. And the bookies at the moment predicting a fairly comfortable qualification for Cyprus. Cilia is currently in 7th place out of the 15 performers. We'll see whether that holds true. Following her in the second running order, we have Serbia, represented by Teodora and with the song Ramonda. Currently borderline predicted to qualify in the 10th position. After that, we will have our favorite, our homeboy from Lithuania, Sylvester Belt, with the song Luktelk. Very comfortable qualification predicted by the bookies in the 3rd position. Will this be the biggest surprise of the night if he doesn't qualify? I think that's very unlikely. No need to comment on that. Following Sylvester, we have Ireland's Bambi Thug with the song Doomsday Blue. Whilst we had our doubts regarding their qualification, they are currently predicted to qualify in the 6th position with a very interesting performance, which we had a sneak peek into from the early rehearsals. Then we're going to move on to a short break with UK's representative, who is not part of our semi-final voting procedure, but will be performing in the final as one of the big fives. So UK is represented by Ollie Alexander and his song Dizzy. Following the exciting performance from Ollie, we have Ukraine in the 5th position in the running order, as noted previously, already predicting a win by Kotrina. but we'll see whether the bookies align. So Ukraine is represented by Jerry Hale and Alona Alona and their song Teresa and Maria. Currently predicted to qualify comfortably in the 2nd position by the bookies. After the Ukraine, we will take a look at Poland's performance, where Luna will sing her song The Tower. Where she is predicted to qualify, currently in the 8th position by the bookies. We'll see what kind of tower she decided to build. We had a lot of speculations in the previous episodes. After the Poland's performance, we will finally see Croatia's performance with Baby Lasagna and his song Rimtim Tagidim. Which has been a huge fan favorite so far, and also echoed by the bookies. Currently, he's being placed in the top position to qualify. No doubts about his qualification. Something has to go very wrong for him to not qualify. Do you agree, guys?
Oh, yeah, definitely. And he is closing the first half pretty much, right? So is this a good time to have a quick discussion about this first half and where do we feel bookies might be going wrong?
I'm sure it's not Baby Lasagna, who I think we all agree will qualify. Is that...
Yeah, definitely. I have my question marks against Cyprus and Serbia. And I'm generally quite surprised that Cyprus is so high up in the odds currently. I think there is, in the finals, from this semifinal, there is place for only one girly bop. And I think it's going to be Luxembourg, not Cyprus. That's my prediction. But I wouldn't call it as a shock non-qualifier. For me, it's a very expected non-qualifier. I'm just generally surprised it's so high up of the bookies.
At least in the rehearsals that we've already seen, the performance was very underwhelming in terms of other girly pops this year. I think for me, it's the biggest surprise in terms of how high Cyprus
exactly.
is placing.
Exactly.
And I think generally very surprising that bookies are predicting all countries from the first half to qualify, which very unlikely
really?
To happen.
That's true. Yeah, that's absolutely unlikely. Guys, place your bets. There is some money to be made here.
Do not encourage betting.
I don't think that's ever happened. Yeah, that all countries, especially from the first half, which historically is considered to be weaker. Now, of course, this year, because they changed the voting rules and you'll be able to vote from the very first song, that will obviously favor the songs performing earlier in the show. But still, all of those first half songs to qualify, absolutely, absolutely impossible.
What do you think, August? Did you have any surprises in the first half?
The Polish Tower. I don't think, at least the snippets that we saw from the rehearsals, she doesn't seem to be singing very well. And I've always found her slightly odd. And I don't know if the performance sells it for me, at least. I don't know how she is predicted to qualify compared with Slovenia, for example, which I find a bit more interesting.
I had the answer for your question, August. It's Polish diaspora. Poland is 100% going through, especially with the UK voting in the semi as well.
I see. The bookies are realistic. They're thinking about what will
exactly.
happen. They're not assessing the song.
They're not assessing the song quality or anything like that. They're not juries. They're thinking realistically what would happen. So Poland is 100% going through, even though the vocals are so shaky. Mm.
And also the staging, just very chaotic.
Very chaotic.
I could not understand what was going on. I mean, we only saw like snippets, so I guess we don't see the full
story. So much is going on. Yeah. Well, there are towers.
Yes.
Plural on stage, and I have a very fun piece of trivia for you guys. Do you remember James Newman performance
with
2021? Two trumpets.
Yes.
Guess who is staging Poland this year?
Really?
Same guy.
Really?
Oh, wow.
Same guy. Apologies, I haven't noted his name, but he's clearly obsessed with big props on stage that come in pairs. So that's his signature move, clearly.
Wow. Yeah. This is crazy. Yeah.
Interesting.
Two towers, then the red LED horse. Did you see that?
Oh, yes, I saw it too, yeah.
For a second, I really thought it was a visual effect because obviously Poland is famous for their visual effects. But I think it's an LED. The commentators are saying it's just an LED. Mm.
And yeah, they had like a Sauron black figure as well dancing with her.
Yeah.
Anyway, it's a lot to consume. One country that I was surprised to see high up in the odds, I really loved their staging, but I don't know if everyone's comfortable with their performance, especially newer viewers. That's Ireland.
Mm.
Very kind of comfortably sitting in. And I know it's kind of only sixth position.
Yeah,
but,
no,
also,
but it's been going up and up and up.
Yeah, going up and also going up in the odds to win as well.
Yeah.
I think the staging helped a lot with that.
Yes. Mm-hmm. Very. Oh, what an improvement from the national final.
I know.
It looks expensive. It looks cinematic. It tells a story.
And you can hear her as well. Something they must have done to the sound. In the national final, I think she was almost mumbling, it seemed.
Yeah, so you're right, Gerda. Some people might not feel comfortable with it and might be slightly scared by the visuals and her image. But it's so unique. it will definitely stand out, and it's going through. No question about that.
You know what I wanted to say? Croatia. Mm-hmm. I saw the performance with the traditional clothes, and I thought that was a cool change because I never fully got those fluffy clothes on him. I thought that it was some sort of imitation of Karija and only that. But now it makes sense with the traditional clothes. I think it's a cool addition, but I don't think they did anything to the performance itself as a spectacle to raise the level apart from the clothes. So I don't know if that may be a disappointment or a missed opportunity compared with Ukraine, you know, that elevates the performance with some props, with big costumes, with something. I don't know. For a Eurovision performance, I would have expected something special, or maybe they're keeping it a surprise. I don't know.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, interesting. I think you mentioned Ukraine, and I think that was one of the other countries that I noted had very significant improvements in their staging.
Yes.
It just looks so epic. I now believe again that...
Yeah. Did you see the 30-second clip released by the broadcaster?
Mm-hmm.
I got the goosebumps that I got when I first listened to the song. Jerry Heil's voice, her climbing up that rock.
Yes. Uh-huh.
And the visuals in the background... I don't know what it's supposed to represent, but for me, it made me feel emotional because I don't know why, but my mind first went to missiles going down on Ukraine, you know, and that's kind of political message and the message around what Ukrainians currently have to go through. And despite that, the strength they have to carry within themselves, right? And that once again gave me goosebumps and... Yeah, I agree. I think it's now back into the conversation, in the winner conversation. And not because it's going to win the jury vote or the public vote, but because I think the winners, the jury and public winners will be different songs. And the ultimate combined winner might be someone who comes second or third with both, right? Yeah. And I think that might be Ukraine.
Mm, absolutely. Interesting.
Should we move on to the second half of the...
Just very quickly on Croatia, because I don't fully agree with you. He introduced quite a bit of pyro in his performance makes it even more fiery. And I find it quite funny that his hometown is sponsoring him. And because pyro is very, very expensive. Not sure if you have looked into how buying visuals and extras on the Eurovision stage looks like, but basically every delegation is provided almost a menu of things and features they can choose from and buy. And pyro is up there amongst the most expensive things you can buy. So if you see pyro on a stage, be certain that they invested quite a bit of money. So Baby Lasagna is sponsored by his hometown.
That's traditional, so cute.
Traditional. Maybe they are, you know, hoping to host it next year.
That's a small village.
The fluffy sleeves. Yes, a lot of people compare them with Karija, but that's also traditional to the region where he comes from.
Right. Okay.
So those big fluffy sleeves was also a part of the traditional clothing.
Now it's clear.
Yeah.
Cool.
Okay, let's move on to the second half of the first semi-final. Performing eighth, we have Iceland, and returning to Eurovision stage, Hera Bjork with a song Scared of Heights. I feel it coming. Ooh, been here before and never got it right. Currently, bookies are not predicting a great result for Hera. She's 15th out of 15 performers of the night and quite clearly predicted not to qualify. And then following Hera's steps, we will have another act from the Big Five representing Germany, Isaac, with the song Always on the Run. And then following them, we will have Slovenia with a very interesting performance by Raven. The song is called Veronica. Very heavy on nudity. Not sure if a lot of parents will be comfortable showing the show to their kids. And the bookies, surprisingly, to me at least, are predicting her to not qualify. And she's predicted in the 12th position. Then to switch things up, performing 10th, we will have Finland with a duo Windows 95 Man and the song No Rules. No rules. Favorite by our Jean short loving enthusiast and general excited figure August.
Yay. Everybody take their pants off.
Right.
Here. Okay. And they are predicted to very comfortably qualify in the fourth position. Now, to bring the speed a little bit down, following them we will have Moldova with again another returner to the Eurovision stage, Natalia Barbu, and her song In the Middle. Again, Bookies are not predicting a very good result for the returners this year. She is predicted to be 14th and to not qualify for the final. But fear not, following her, we have a very interesting performance by Sweden, the host of this year's Eurovision. The duo representing Sweden, actually Norwegians, Marcus and Martinus, with a song Unforgettable. They will surely bring a very interesting performance to the night. It will surely be unforgettable. And wrapping up the night, we have another four performers hoping to qualify for the grand final. So performing 12th is Azerbaijan, another duo, Fari and Ilkin Dovlatov.
Yeah.
Yes, Ilkin
Dovlatov. I don't know why he became such a like inside joke for us, but he did.
For those who have not listened to our podcast, Ilkin Dovlatov is our favorite performer.
A mythical character.
A mythical character that appears out of nowhere. They are performing the song, and I will butcher the name of the song because I didn't understand some of the letters, but let's give it a go. Ozunle Apar. Unfortunately, they are not predicted to qualify. They're currently 13th. And then following them is another duo. Wow, what a heavy night for duos. We have Australia and the duo Electric Fields performing a song called One Milkali or One Blood. Milkali love, Milkali love, it's raining love. Currently predicted to not qualify, but very borderline in 11th position. Interesting trivia fact, there was only one other time when Australia didn't qualify. So that would be an interesting result for Australia, I should say. Following Australia, we have Portugal, and representing Portugal this year is Yolanda with the song Grito. Currently predicted to qualify in 9th position. And to wrap things up for the night, we have returning to Eurovision after 30 years of non-participation, Luxembourg represented by Tali and her song Fighter. She is predicted to qualify quite comfortably in the 5th position. What do you guys think about the Bookies' predictions?
Right, so just like what I said about Luxembourg in Cyprus, when I said that I think there is only one spot for a girly bop. Similarly, I think there is only one spot for a ballad.
Wow. Okay.
And we have two clear ballads, Serbia and Portugal. Unless we also want to describe Azerbaijan as a ballad.
And Slovenia.
Yeah. Okay. Slovenia is its own category.
Yeah.
It's a piece of art.
It is a piece of
art. It is a piece of art. But between Serbia and Portugal, I think only one will qualify. I struggle with choosing between the two, but one of them will be out. And I think Slovenia might qualify. That's where I disagree with the bookies. It's so interesting. It's captivating. Yeah. All of these naked bodies around her moving, and her voice is certainly not shaky.
She's a real witch. I think Bambi's a real witch, and she is a real witch too.
Two witches. Well, we're lucky. But I think, I agree. Slovenia for me is the biggest dark horse of the evening. I think it looks great. Maybe the staging could be, I don't know. I didn't like from the rehearsals the very bright blue color scheme. I wanted something darker. They could potentially change it. It could, maybe without even changing it, it may look better when we see the whole performance. Maybe it's kind of building up to something like a big reveal. But nonetheless, like, her voice is just phenomenal. I don't know if you guys saw Eurovision. Social media accounts have been releasing these snippets of artists singing in the showers.
Yeah.
And most of them sound horrible because the acoustics are so bad. And then Slovenia, she has no problem singing in bad acoustics. In any kind of acoustics, she sounds great. So yeah, I would be really surprised if she doesn't qualify.
Exactly. Like. Great voice and just visually so interesting.
Mm-hmm.
The other one that you said is borderline and would be a surprise if they don't qualify, because they normally qualify, Australia. And this year, they are also bringing something interesting. I wasn't too captivated by the music video, but I think now that I saw them on stage, they are really bringing different culture onto the European stage. They will have their aboriginal instruments on stage. The chemistry between the performers look very, very good. So I think they have a chance to qualify.
Anything from you, August?
I am surprised by Portugal having such a high probability of qualifying. Do you guys know why that is? Is it also diaspora?
Not sure.
Or do people like the song genuinely? I don't know how.
I think a lot of people actually like that song and connect with it. I know us three, we don't, but she can sing, right? We can't say that she can't sing, and it's interesting musical composition, you know, not your basic pop song.
I say down with Portugal. Go Slovenia. Take that spot.
Yeah, I probably agree with you.
I mean, one of them has to go. There's only 10 that can make it.
Yeah, so I think Cyprus will go. I think Portugal will go, basically opening up slots for Australia and Slovenia.
Mm.
I wouldn't mind seeing Azerbaijan in the final either. But
just to say Ilkin Dovlatov's name again.
Exactly. But I'm not sure who else would go. I think one ballot will have to go through. So that's Serbia. And yeah.
In terms of like shock non-qualifiers, I did think that Finland's performance may not land with some people.
Mm-hmm.
I support them. But I think it's so out there, and we have so many kind of fun entries this year that it may feel like a bit too much. I also noted that they had some issues with their props in the first rehearsal.
Really? Which props?
The gene egg.
The gene egg.
The jug.
What happened to it?
It just closed while he was still in it.
Oh. No.
Yeah, yeah, couldn't get out.
Surely you can fix that.
You work through
that's
these
so
issues,
funny.
But
the egg closed.
Yeah, but it's one of those props that could ruin the performance.
Right.
If you can't get out.
Yeah.
So yeah, but yeah, generally, I don't know. Sometimes there are some great songs that found support, like Latvia from 2 years ago, come to mind with the salad song, and then they just don't qualify. So I worry that something similar might happen with Finland.
Not comparable. Sorry, that song, that Latvian song, Cringe Fest. This is a peak performance. Beauty and art.
I think they will safely qualify. And also, Henry's voice really improved. He's singing even better. He's belting even some higher notes.
Yes, top vocal. We voted them for best vocal in the last category, remember? We all agreed.
I think you voted and we didn't agree.
Didn't we all agree? Yeah.
And then as a special bonus for the hardcore Eurovision fans, we will have Benjamin Ingrosso performing a medley of his songs. So for those who don't follow Eurovision as closely as some hardcore fans around this table, Benjamin Ingrosso participated in Eurovision in 2018 with the song Dance You Off. We really like that song. I'm really keen to see his performance again. So just overall good news for me.
Good news. And guys, which one are you mostly excited about? Which one you can't wait to see? For me, I'm going to go with Ukraine. I really can't wait to see the full performance.
Hmm.
I don't know why you asked that question, because it's obviously Lithuania.
Yeah, I mean, I was going to say Ukraine as well, but Lithuania, Sylvester. I watch his interviews. He looks calm. He looks ready. He looks charismatic.
They haven't changed that much since the national final.
Not much.
But they improved some of the visuals.
Yep.
To make them more impactful.
The dancers.
The dancers.
Have cool costumes.
The selfies, the LED selfies are now moving.
The LED floor.
And the floor. Yeah.
Cool. Yeah. Overall, very excited for Tuesday evening. Tune in to watch it. We will certainly be debriefing the whole Eurovision week afterwards, and no doubt we'll have opinions and shocks and surprises in store. And also tune in for our semi-final 2 guides, which will come out later this week. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
Bye.